Welcome back, everybody. Time to go to where are we going? The high school. That's where we're going. Go to destination.
Are we sure this is right? I'm not seeing anything weird.
I have no doubt. This place gives me the same sensation as when I touched the birdcage.
Think this is what would bring me back here.
Getting nostalgic?
I suppose so. Even though it's only been about half a year. Still, I had no idea Alice Hiragi graduated from Shujin.
I didn't either. And I figured a student council president would know better than anyone about celebrity graduates.
Perhaps she had a past here that she wished to erase.
What do you mean?
Those voices we heard in her jail. Those cutting words and that painful cry. I don't know whether she was one of the instigators or the victim of such bullying. However she experienced it. Left such a gaping wound in her heart that she refuses to even acknowledge the truth of the matter.
And that truth took place right here.
So that's why Shujin has a secret room.
High school for you.
We should get moving. What's next?
We may not be in Shibuya, but this place is still linked to its jail. Inputting the proper Emma keyword should permit access as usual.
Okay, let's try it. Everybody ready?
No.
Yeah, we're ready. Keyword, Wonderland.
Keyword successfully entered. Beginning navigation.
That's gonna be interesting.
So, it's a classroom?
Is this what a school is like? It's rather different than how the internet makes it appear.
The cognitive distortion's really strong here. What's going on?
Hey, look! A ghost!
Are you seriously crying? Ugh, how pathetic. Trying to get us to go easy on you. You tricked him the same way too, didn't you?
No, I'd never do that.
What? What is this?
God, you're disgusting. Serious! Why are you still alive?
Goddamn.
Do us a favor. And die already.
Oh, what's about to happen? Oh, she's twitching. What the hell?
What the hell?
Careful, here it comes.
Let's go.
Can't you get it through your thick skull? No one wants you around.
Oh shit, what the hell is going on? This thing just flipped out of nowhere!
The room's also changed. As these prison cells.
No time! Here it comes!
Look sharp, folks!
Okay.
We should avoid wasting energy on our attacks. Let's read the enemy's movements and respond in kind.
Right here!
Your face really pisses me off!
What?
Why won't you just go on and die for us?
Holy shit! Hey yo, why is my health gone? Hit me.
This one, this one, okay, this one.
Are you supposed to be down in the dump? What are you doing batting your lashes at some guy?
What is with this thing?
I don't know. Whatever that thing is. It's horrible.
It holds up with the spoon, too. It's supposed to have the birdcage key in it. But this.
The key is most assuredly here. It must be hidden somewhere within the cell.
Let's go. With this.
I'm not exactly fit to search for it now. Focus on the enemy first.
Strike. Persona.
You're weak. Oh, okay, cool.
Ravage them.
Here with those weaknesses!
That's Joker for ya!
Did I get that one?
Okay, I can do it! Keep it going!
So crazy!
What are you gonna get again? No, not a Moki. I don't want a Moki. Alright, so you're not weak to electricity, but you are weak to wind.
Truly terrible things said in the classroom as well.
I believe we've seen why Alex drove so far to wipe the records of the time. Sorry.
The lock on and switching who was coming up. Where do you go?
This thing can teleport? Watch out for sneak attacks, everyone! Hang in there! Keep us up! Go kick some butt out there!
Showtime!
Succubus.
Here. Let's go, get wrecked. That did like no damage. Oh shit. Oh balls. Everyone getting freaking getting wrecked. 20 all allies.
This one.
Thanks.
Okay.
I'm so grateful.
We almost got him. We almost got him.
The enemy raised their attack tower. You do not want to get hit right now.
Hell yeah!
Got him.
That did it.
Hang on. Something's up.
A keyhole? Or a lock?
What do we got here?
What? What?
Okay. That unlock the throne room or what?
Okay.
Whoa, badass!
What was that rumbling?
The birdcage in the jail is now unlocked. We will be able to access it.
For real?
It appears our most recent target held the key.
In other words, we defeated the warden guarding the key.
A warden in Alice's memories. A key to the cage in her jail. So a different shadow held the key, not Alice's?
What are you going on about?
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking how many differences there are from the palaces.
Good point. The palaces don't have any rooms like these, or wardens guarding keys in hidden locations.
It's as if the more we learn, the messier the situation gets.
If it weren't for Sophie, we wouldn't have even made it here.
Have I been helpful to the Phantom Thieves?
Mm-hmm. You know it.
Praise accepted.
Mm-hmm. Well, we'll praise you all you want later. We've got a birdcage to bust open.
True. We have one last task in the real world first.
Let's send Alice the calling card and take back those desires.
Hell yeah.
Okay, all that's left is send in the calling card. What should it say?
We're after the desires that Alice is seizing from the people whose hearts she changed, right?
Then don't we have to write something like, "We shall take back the desires you've seized"?
Smart. Using the same logic that works on treasures is probably our best shot.
Once the desire takes form, we can steal it. If we return the victims their own desires,
everyone should return to normal.
So, what'll happen to Alice then?
Well, she should be having a change of heart and confessing soon after.
Actually, that's not set in stone.
What we're stealing this time are the desires that Alice seized from others.
I have a question though. Because in the palaces, the ruler of the palace didn't know said palace existed. That's like their own like warped version of whatever they thought, you know, that they ruled over or whatever. But in this case, how there's no way for Alice's shadow to be able to steal somebody else's desires. The people who are flipping like that shouldn't be flipping like that. Just because, and Alice doesn't know it's happening. You know what I mean? So I think Alice is able to actually go into that world and do it on her own. Because, you know, how is it that the desires are being stolen and then those people are having changes of hearts from a shadow, you know, in the other world? Like, how is that a thing? Like, how is that able to happen without the ruler of said jail at least being able to manipulate it to her own advantage. So,
I'm talking to her. Own desire or ambition, or like the treasure we found in palaces. There's no way of knowing whether or not Alice's heart will be changed.
Even if we rescue her victims, without a change of heart in Alice, this will just turn into a pointless cycle.
But if the calling card works, her desire will manifest inside the birdcage. That creates a high probability that we'll encounter Alice's shadow there.
We did cause quite a scene destroying the lock.
Whether through words or fists, don't we still have the opportunity to change her heart via her shadow?
Then let's do it! Let's take her head on!
Let's go.
Oh, sorry. I know that's the dangerous approach, but if you guys are all up for it, I want to rescue Alice too. Not just her victims. Alice said she wanted to be a ray of light that could inspire people suffering through life.
You mean when she was on TV? I don't know if she really meant all that.
Well, I do. I get why she said it. Because of all the bullying in her past. I mean, doesn't it seem like we saw part of Alice's trauma in the secret room?
Trauma? It's like an invisible wound in a person's heart. It comes from living through painful experiences.
A wound in a heart.
Maybe that trauma's the whole reason the jail formed.
Trauma distorted Alice's heart, giving birth to the jail. That is very similar to Palace Generation. I've gotta say, it's possible.
But how is that trauma relevant to Alice's current behavior?
This is just a hunch, but I think she sees what she's doing as some kind of revenge. Against the kinds of girls who treated her badly.
Stealing someone's dude right in front of her as revenge to Alice? Oh, that's pretty sick.
But her shadow's operation is way too massive for that to be all. She just has too many victims already.
What if she simply kept escalating because no one was there to stop her? Becoming a monarch must create an awful amount of distortion.
All that only makes me want to help Alice more. If her heart's grown that distorted, then I want her to at least remember how it feels being a ray of light for somebody. Is she beyond helping at this point? I don't know. But there has to be someone who at least tries. We can't just abandon Alice.
Oh, Lady On.
You're right.
Thanks.
I'm with you. Let's do it.
No objections.
Gotta agree with her.
Either. However, should we engage her in combat, we must avoid taking her life at all costs.
Absolutely. That's out of the question.
Best case scenario, we just talk her out of it.
Guys, do you think I could write the calling card this time? There's something I need to tell her personally. Thanks. It'll be great.
Writing a calling card? Need any help?
Ooh, you can help me with the phrasing, Sophia.
Awesome. All we gotta figure out now is the delivery.
I may have a plan for that.
This is a special reunion of the Phantom Thieves. We gotta do this right.
Hell yeah. Let's go.
Hey.
Now then.
Save. Exit. Let me go see if I could go purchase any more healing items and stuff like that. Okay, once we send the calling card, boss fight time. Oh, where am I going? Hello?
Hmm?
There. No, they're sold out. That was, because that one sold out, all the other ones are most likely sold out too. So, might as well just send the calling card and see what happens. Hello?
looking for today? Which one? How many would you like? You want put it to good use, okay? You want the thank you very much. Who is it for? Which one? You want this one? You want to equip that? Put it to good use, okay? Who is it for? Which one? Having trouble deciding? Who is it for? What are you selling? How many? Are you sure? How many? Are you sure? How many? Are you sure? Are you sure? How many? Are you sure? Who is it for? Which one? You want this one? Do you want to equip that? Put it to good use, okay? How many? Are you sure?
I'll just add this.
Well, sorry about that, everyone. My game crashed once again, so that's what happens when you get a budget PC. Hey, Yusuke, you okay? Goddamn. Alright, well, Debating. Yeah, here. I'll send it. That night. Let's go.
In other news, Akira Konoe, founder of Medice, announced a joint project with one-time rival company Pineapple. Tech heads are fired up with anticipation of the news, awaiting further details.
We back.
Okay, folks, listen up!
Good evening. Been a while, huh?
Perhaps you remember us.
We are the Phantom Thieves.
And we're back in action with a new heart in our sights. A wicked witch who treats people like toys. Alice Hiragi!
You pretend you're a ray of light, but all you do is hurt people to indulge your own darkness. You're a bad person, and bad people have to be stopped.
This guy's a fanboy. I know it.
Tonight, we're taking them all back.
Let's go. It's me, your boy. Today, this shall be started. Let's do this.
Let's go.
Right, tonight we take back stolen desires. Oh, yeah. So excited. Our first jail coming to a close.
I'll I'll just add this.
There we go. Save. Excellent. Well, that's going to do it for this episode. So if you guys enjoyed it, please consider liking, sharing, and subscribing. And I'll see you guys in the next one.